Welcome to the CorpVault channel. In our previous video, we started discussing Commvault Common Technology Engine, Core Fundamentals. In this video, we will continue discussing the other aspects. Please like, share, comment or suggest. Subscribe for more videos. And you can follow us on Instagram. Let's discuss instance, BackupSet, and SubClient. Instance. The instance level is only present for database IDAs. Many database applications allow for the existence of multiple instances on the same client. Each instance can be managed separately to meet any unique requirements. BackupSet. The BackupSet is a logical entity that defines a complete, separate, and recoverable view of the data. In the case of database IDAs, it could be an individual database for SQL or tablespace for Oracle. In the case of file system IDAs, Commvault creates one default backup set for all file system data. Normally, you would only require one backup set. If you wanted to have different underlying structures, with redundant data copied directly from the client, additional backup sets could be created. Subclient. A subclient is a logical entity used to divide the data within the backup set. For each installed IDA, Commvault automatically creates a default subclient that contains all the data for the type IDA. However, if you want to backup specific data, you can create additional subclients and assign the desired data to each. The default subclient will then contain the remaining data of the backup set that is not allocated to user-defined subclients. To understand this concept better, try this analogy. Consider all of the file system data on the client server to be a whole pie. Now, call the pie a backup set. If you wanted to divide the pie, you would cut it into pieces or subclients. No matter how you slice it, each piece of pie is unique and is subtracted from the original pie. Simply stated, the data defined in the newly created subclient is no longer part of the total data defined by the default subclient. Therefore, each subclient contains a unique portion of the data and is mutually exclusive of all other subclients within that backup set. Multiple subclients allow you to backup different parts of the system in parallel, at different times, or at different frequencies. Please note, by default, the index cache is made at the backup set level. If needed, you can change it to be made at subclient level. The next topic to discuss is data paths. During a backup operation, the source server sends data to the media agent for archiving on the media. During a backup operation, or restore, the media agent accesses data on the storage media and sends it to the destination server. The connection set up between the media agent, source, or destination server is called a data pipe or data stream. A data stream is a data mover used to move data back and forth between a data source and a media agent, or between two media agents. It consists of a shared memory component on each system for multi-thread processing, with multiple connections between the components. It handles all data encryption, compression, and disk I/O. The data stream takes advantage of the shared memory speed and efficiency to double up on data movement functions. Each stream opens multiple connections between the data source and the media agent. One of these streams is used for control, while the others move data. Whether performing local backups to a media agent installed on the same system or over the network to a media agent installed on a different system, The data stream processes remain the same. When provided with sufficient resources, for example, bandwidth, CPU, disk I/O, a single data stream can stream multiple storage devices across a network, at optimum speed. Simultaneous data streams can be run, from one or more data sources, to one or more media agents at the same time. The data stream will make use of all the available bandwidth, unless throttled back using controls, built into the Commvault client software. Let's discuss libraries. Libraries are hardware or software entities that manage a set of storage devices and media, for example magnetic disk storage, or tape drives and tapes. Even a single removable media drive, or standalone, is managed as a library, with a tracked set of media. Access and control of all libraries in a CommCell is managed by the Media Manager service on the CommServ. Local access and control is handled by the media agents. Depending on the storage environment and the backup requirements, a single media agent can be configured to access multiple libraries. Likewise, multiple media agents can be configured to access a single library, called shared library. All protected data, regardless of a backup or restore operations, must pass through a media agent and a library. For disk libraries, data paths to storage volumes are either local or network. A physical library can be attached to a media agent in different ways. Directly via SCSI, SAN attached, IP based. Commvault supports all major storage devices and libraries. Media agents are the primary control agent for media changes and tape devices. The Media and Library Manager service on the CommServ host determines the required tape media and its location. It then determines which media agent has control of the media changer to load or unload the tape. A list of currently tested configurations, also called hardware compatibility matrix, is available on Commvault's website. We will end this video here. In our next video, we will try cover other fundamental aspects. Please hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe to our channel if not already done so. Thank you. Do subscribe for more videos.